Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Lobotomy Corporation Season 3. We're going to pick up right where we ended yesterday here as we continue in our adventures and get everyone skilled up, ready to go for the ultimate showdown against you-know-who, Gebura. Now, obviously, I'm recording this immediately following yesterday's episode. We were just about to phase transition here. I'm recording this immediately after yesterday's episode, so obviously, I have not been able to look at feedback yet. I'm probably going to do one more episode after this, and then hopefully I'll be caught up in the first comment section. Now, I just noticed that Northern Lion, he did get the payout from Fire Chicken again, so I'm pretty happy about that, considering that he had that at one point and then died. So that's good for NL. Let's get little Daisy here. We're not going to spend too much longer in this day, though. We just need to get through this day. Get our PE requirements, and that'll be it. What's going on here? Oh, that's the... I was like, what is this? What is on fire over here? But turns out it's just the process of understanding. Okay, Mathis, let's go ahead and put you over here. But I'm also really thankful and relieved that people are okay with the 45-minute episodes. I know I keep banging on about that, but something that I don't have a lot of these days is time. And people being okay... People being okay with allowing me to do what I usually do, but more efficiently is a huge help to me. It's also a big stress relief as well. Not having to do like hour and a half long episodes and killing myself time wise anyway. So Dodger died, which means that we still need to get red shoes. It doesn't really matter if the red shoes get out. It just charmed somebody, but. Fine. No meltdowns down here. Fire Chicken. We don't care about the note. Well, I guess we could do the notepad. NL can do the notepad here. And then Maggie can do repression. We'll have NL go work with Fire Chicken. For some reason, Lily's here. I think I may have selected her, so I'll have her go work with the Meat Lantern. There we go. Make sure. Okay, Queen of Hatred is melting down. Okay, so NL can work with Fire Chicken again. Husky's going to have to go back and deal with Queen of Hatred one more time. Hurt's currently being charmed. Anar's got censored. As soon as Lily gets here, we can send her to go work with Meat Lantern. Okay, so Meat Lantern's gonna get out. Again, we just need to watch. Which hallway he gets in. Now hopefully the game doesn't screw us again and put him in the exact same hallway, but if Dodger's death taught us anything, it's that the only conceivable thing I could have done was to instruct her to walk this way, which meant queuing her up to work with a painting. But I mean, that's not something that you would expect to ever see. I mean, the chances of that happening are so remote that it's pretty ridiculous. Okay, so he's already spawned. We don't have rabbit protocol for me to check exactly where he is, though. So we're going to have to do this old school style and just look for him. Mathis, get out of the hallway. Now, I'm not totally 100% down with doing a dusk phase here if we don't have to. It's not safe for us to just let Meat Lantern go unfounded either. That is not him. We still don't know where exactly he is. You would think that you'd be able to find like a flower sticking out of the ground fairly easy in this game, but you'd be surprised. That came from over here. Yeah, there he is. Okay. Little Daisy Go do that. Does Kurt have a... Kurt? No. Little Daisy can take care of him. So it's good that Husky... It's a good thing that Husky got out of there before he spawned. Okay, so Husky, why don't you come work with nothing there? Make sure he did. I'm making sure he didn't walk that way. Force can keep working with the mountain. I don't really trust anyone else to work with the mountain. I mean, even though I said that the mountain really isn't all that big of a deal, it's still the mountain, you know? Like, he's still dangerous. Northern Lion can get some insight work there. Maggie also needs some insight work. We need everyone over 100. What's the other one that we need 100? Justice. Lots of justice. Eden. Daisy should still be down here, so little Daisy can work on Monkbro. Good job, Lily. While Lily's down here, she could work some stuff as well. She needs some fortitude, so we'll get some fortitude there with Red Shoes. Neville can work with Knight of Despair since she's over here. There you go. She actually needs fortitude work. Actually, you know what, Neville, why don't you work with the fire chicken? So we'll go to the end of today and then call it there. It's not my intention to do a dusk phase here. If we don't have to. Even though the Amber Dusk is not that terrible to deal with, it's something that we've dealt with before. It's just going to take a long time, and it's needlessly redundant at this point. There's no reason for us to do that. Let's just get some more justice work going, stripping. Who else can we repress? I know that we can repress the mountain. What's Force's... What is Force's justice rating? He's at 106, okay. I really don't want to. I don't want to risk someone dying to the mountain. That should take us to 2. Rob is probably good to work with nothing there one more time, but I'm not going to risk it. We're gonna play conservatively here. I want little Daisy to get one more swing on Mungbro. We got little Daisy, and we have one more slot remaining, which we will let Eden finish off in celebration of his getting the pipe from Darebro. Don't take that out of context, you freaking weirdos. That should be it. Once everyone's done, we'll be good to go. That one, waiting on little Daisy, and I think we're all golden. We don't have anyone out of control. I'm doing a double check real fast. Discount double check. Yeah, man, we lost Dodger to complete BS, but whatever. All right, we got Virtue of the Soul cleared. I mean, that one was gonna be easy because we've already done that before. So good gains all around. For Wayne, Wayne got to a Temperance and Prudence level 5. That's great. Trippin's almost at 100 Justice. Not quite there yet. Lily did get a little bit of Fortitude help at the very end there. Same with Husky. Oh, wow. Husky getting huge Temperance upgrades from working with the Queen of Hatred. Excuse me. Wow, Rob gained 20 HP as well. That's phenomenal. Cry got a little bit of work. I kind of neglected Cry there. Sorry, Cry. And little Daisy. Little Daisy got... She's over 100. She went from 67 to 100 and something. Wow. Those are some big-time plays, little Daisy. Okay. My dear employees, I hope you all put on the gas mask. We know who that is, and we may actually need her. I'll hang his head over my bed. Only then I can fall asleep without having a nightmare. Sadness shall say, "Be gone, die!" But desire wants eternity. An immortality that can never be abolished. I feel like I've seen that one before. This one I don't know. This one I do know. This one is scary, but the first time that we ran into it, we were ill prepared. That was in season one. If I remember correctly, she also, that's also like a really good justice skill up. I do not recognize this one. I only sort of recognize this one. I'm going to go with a new one again, because I don't really want to metagame this too much. I don't know if we've seen this one before. We may have, and I just don't remember. I mean, it's been over a year and a half now. Having Melted Love is... Her gear is so good. So is her weapon. Her weapon is a... it's a very high damage dealing range attack that deals black damage. Her armor is real good, too. We could use it. We need another Aleph armor. But this could also be Aleph. So... I'm going to go with the one that I don't know. We'll see. This place where there was only silence, perhaps it was because only you and I are here, has gotten a bit livelier thanks to the Zephyras. Unlike me, they were weak and lacked rationality. They made so many mistakes that annoyed me greatly. I did not approve of you placing Zephyras here. But you told me that your atonement and the awakening of the Zephyras were key to untying the knot. I didn't know what you were talking about. You also told me I wouldn't understand. You even blocked me from interfering with that relationship, saying that it must be left to be solely your role. You're right, right as always. Even if I stay here repeating this endlessly, it's probably not worth understanding until the end. To quote one of your favorite lines, machines should act like machines. But I had to play the role of observer, had to endure all the pain that others forgot. I don't think I have to point that out again. Whatever you say, Angela. Gorsh! By the way, yes, everyone's been telling me that Banah is a female, but we're still going to go with Goofy. Gorsh, would you like to open the extraction team? Oh, yeah. Why, sure, Banah. Sounds good. Okay, so this is going to be the... We should have gained enough lobotomy points to make our... To make our move on Gibeira. We don't know what this is. I don't know what the one on the right is. I know for sure that was Melting Love on the left there. So it's safe to assume that this might be an Aleph. But of course, I said that about the Knight of Despair, and we she's not. So let's get her. We've already got her gear. Good. And we have 20, so we have just enough to make all of our nameless gobs, but we are going to have to sacrifice one of our actual employees. So the question is who? We need someone strong enough to not only live... Well, no, we need two people. Because the employee who sticks with Flesh Idol is going to die. When they die, all the abnormalities... will be released. Every single one in the... I think it's every single one in the entire facility. Or it could just be that department. But I'm pretty sure it's all of them. We've never tried this. We've tried this strat with another abnormality with the shelter. But never with Flesh Idol. So I'm almost positive it's all of them, though. So let's unload everyone. And today's the day. We're going to do it. Or at least try to. We need to find a candidate who doesn't have all that great of ego gift payouts, but is still strong enough to live through the micromanagement. Now, preemptively before the last episode was recorded, I was taking stock to see who exactly we would need, but I neglected to think of the fact that we needed two people to do it. So one person has to stay with the Flesh Idol long enough to get past 90 seconds. Well, technically 45 seconds, and then they'll be healed. But the second person has to actually live through the rest of the day. And that second person doesn't have to be a scrub. You know, it comes down to, it needs to be either Husky. Did we get the weapon from the mountain now that I think about it? We haven't. We almost got it. I was wondering where that, I was like, wait, I feel like we're missing something. I don't know why I just thought of that. We need somebody with the best armor, but also has the most resistance to like stress and physical, which is Baynard. Baynard can at least survive the pulses from Blue Star, who's going to get out. This comes down, I have to, essentially what happens is, what's going to happen is I have to micro Baynard for this entire episode to keep him alive. So, the rest of this episode, it might just be more theorizing and more attempts here. But I'm going to go with the experimental attempt first. So this is what my plan is. My plan is going to be having Baynard get the blessing from the Knight of Despair. So he takes half damage from everything but pale damage, which to my knowledge, none of the abnormalities that we currently possess deal pale damage. Then all we need left is just a sacrifice to the flesh idol to get everything out. We're gonna hire a bunch of nameless people and just throw them in. And I mean, every department has to have one employee. And don't worry, they're not real people; they're robots. Don't worry. So I think Baynard is gonna be our man for this attempt here. As all, I mean, look, if you need a big time player, Baynard is gonna be that person. Who else to carry the team but Baynard? Seriously, Baynard is going to be it. Now the question is, who is going to take one for the team and die to the flesh idol? Someone who doesn't have all that many great ego gifts. And not Daisy. But they need to be strong enough to, they need to be strong enough SP-wise to keep, to stay alive long enough. And Marie's got, her stats are so good. We can't get rid of Marie. I don't know how much SP it takes overall. Neville might be it. What does Kurt have? Increases white damage by 5%. What does Neville have? She doesn't. Okay, so Neville doesn't have any gifts. I think Neville is going to be the one who sets us up, and then of course we'll remake her. So it's going to be Neville and Baynard, and this is just going to be. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. We need 8 people. This is going to be our attempt at this. 1, 2. Thank you for applying for Lobotomy Corporation, everyone. I'm glad you showed up here. Yeah, by all means, grab a coffee. Sure, go on. Yeah, there's beef jerky and sodas over there if you're not a big coffee drinker. I hear you on that. I ain't a coffee drinker either, brother. Welcome. Now, I'm going to assign you, just because you all come highly recommended and highly qualified, I'm going to assign you all to be in charge of your own department. Yes, every single one of you. That is right, including you, London. We were so impressed with your resumes. We are very eager to get you up in there and working. So, I know, pinch yourself, right? What's that? You need some gear? No. Gears are for crutches. You don't need any gear. You all are good and qualified enough for these positions that we are certain you don't need any of our very expensive, very valuable gear. So thank you all very much for applying, and make sure that you will all receive a raise after today. That's right. I know. What's that? Oh no, it's Neville. Neville's just here. She's gonna be one of your supervisors, and Baynard is here to make sure that well, he's the supervisor to the supervisor. Don't worry, you won't see either one of them. Just worry about your own teams. We're very excited to have you here. We can't wait to see you get involved. And we actually hired one too many people, so yeah, you can go here, Joel. Sure. And yeah. Now, I will say that we are going to be testing a couple things here. We are going to be testing some stuff. So if you hear an alarm or you hear some banging or something like that, don't worry. It is just a controlled, meaningless test. It is not going to do anything that affects your job. I promise. I promise you. So, if you have any questions, you can call me day or night. Here's my personal cell phone number. You can take it. Take my card. Yes, you can take my cards. There you go. You all have your assignments. Very good. And enjoy your first day of Lobotomy Corporation. Welcome to the core. Depression. Okay. So first things first. Baynard is going to get the blessing from... Oh, we have had her. It's Little Red Riding Hood. Okay. Or sorry, Little Red Hood, I should say. So that was red. Yeah, I probably should have taken Melted in Love, but oh well. Having red here will help us out a bit. Yeah, so we are familiar with her. Okay, Baynard got it perfect. He is no longer able to work on anyone, but that's okay because all we're doing is we're using the Knight of Despair for the blessing. Okay, Baynard, we're gonna put you somewhere safe. We need to get away from all the dangerous abnormalities. Excuse me. All right, Baynard's in position. Neville, I promise you, when you come back, you will have all your gear again. We got you. We'll get you taken care of. And thank you for doing this, Neville. We have plenty of a PE to get to rebuy the gear. Here we go. We have gone to the point of no return now. Neville has to survive 90 seconds. Now, hopefully, if this all works out, hopefully, once Gabura's HP hits zero, that'll end the day. Not started healing yet, so we're not at 45 seconds. Apparently we are. And away we go. Baynard should be good there. I need to make sure he doesn't get slept. And he got slept. Baynard, you gotta wake up. Now's not the time. I had to move Baynard. I don't want him to get in contact with Void Dream. If Vera's in there, she's with Blue Star. Spencer's out. I mean, everyone's out. Following Maynard? We need to have him in the elevator so we can teleport if we have to. I can't do anything about the beeping. Why is this a thing? Why is this a thing? Thank you. Okay, Baynard can go back in the... The world was that. Oh, that was Black Swan. Nothing there is out. Welcome to the Aleph Showdown, everyone. Place your bets right now. Place your bets. We've got the mountain. We've got nothing there. We've got Black Swan and Big Bird and everybody else. Little Red Hood taking a lot of damage from the mountain. Mountain is fully evolved. I repeat, mountain is fully evolved. Blue Star is still active. So is Gabura. Taking lots of damage, and it's not looking very good for Red Hood. Is one more hit. She's going to go down. Down goes Red. Nothing there, still working on Big Bird. Now turning his head to the mountain. Here comes Black Swan, going to be making his way up to the upper decks of Lobotomy Corporation. Baynard is sitting in the back, just chilling out, doing nothing. We need to watch out for him, and he does not get hit by you-know-who. Snow White's apple was out as well. Black Swan making his way up to the upper level. Meanwhile, nothing there, and the mountain squabbing back and forth here. Gabura going after the Queen of Hatred. Blue Star still down there, just pulsing away. Here comes Monk coming in from the right side. Baynard is still just standing there doing nothing. Good job, Baynard. Nothing there, and the mountain still fighting here. It looks like it is going to be the mountain taking the lead, although nothing there did take down part of the mountain's morph. Is now only level 2. Gabura still sitting inside of the disciplinary department. Alruune is going to be sitting next to Baynard, just chilling out and not doing anything. Blue Star slowly whittling down the red mist, I should say. There's a lot of colors going on everywhere. The mountain is back up now and making its way up to the upper levels. It looks like nothing there is chasing him. No, he's not going to go up. Black Swan, what are you doing? Black Swan coming down here, going after nothing there. The mountain, meanwhile, he's going after somebody. I'm not sure who. If he's going after Baynard, we're going to have to move Baynard a little bit. Baynard cannot walk anywhere near any of the abnormalities right now. Otherwise, he'll be in a lot of trouble. Baynard's going to move up to the top over here, and the mountain's coming right after him. No, he's not going after Baynard. He's going after another body to try to get his evolved form back. There you see the big fire coming over here from the Queen of Hatred. Gabura still sitting there doing nothing. The mountain has reclaimed his final form, going back to level 3. Nothing there chasing him, possibly, or possibly going after Baynard. We're not sure. Things are getting a little laggy right now. I don't know why. Let's see where nothing there ends up going. We may need to move Baynard in as a precautionary measure here. Baynard, the only one for the home team. Who matters? Nothing there is going after Baynard. Nothing there is going after Baynard. We may need to intervene here a little bit and slow down. Nothing there. Things are getting just slightly choppy here. Baynard's been shot by nothing there. Baynard's still running away from nothing there. I'm not sure why nothing there is going after Baynard. Baynard needs to get around the corner here and turn back around to the elevator. He needs to connect nothing there with the mountain while staying alive from all the other abnormalities that are currently out. Taking a look at the Red Mist, she is still fighting Black Swan. Blue Star still remains untouched. The frames are being destroyed right now. Don't ask me why it's so framey. I couldn't tell you. I can't even move Maynard. Maynard is... Nothing there is still definitely going after Maynard. But here comes the mountain. This would be so much easier if we just had the shelter. It took me that long to try to draw a box here. Baynard's gonna try to lead nothing there to the mountain. The mountain's not moving for some reason. I'm not entirely sure why. Baynard, he could take a hit from the mountain. Let's have Baynard walk through here. Make sure there's none of the, I don't think there's any of the thorns. Nothing there, hot on the trail of Baynard. Oh, the Queen of Hatred teleported up here near Baynard as well. Now he's gonna get, they're gonna hook up with nothing there, who instantly starts attacking the Queen of Hatred. And here comes the mountain. Baynard's done it. He's connected him. The mountain is out. And currently going after nothing there. It's 2-on-1 down here. Nothing there versus the Queen of Hatred and the mountain. Baynard trying to get away safely somewhere. Silent Orchestra has indeed gone back here. It's back down to the mountain versus nothing there. Coming at you live from 2 FPS. this isn't even sped up, by the way. If I sped this up, it would go even worse. Okay, Maynard, you need to move up here. Okay, Gabura is moving. So, Baynard, slow your roll for a second. Let's keep you here. It's actually running smoother now that I put it on times three. The mountain's going somewhere. Mountain is back down to level 2 now. Oh no, he's level 3 again, and he's gonna clash with nothing there yet again. Gabura is down here now. And it's actually incredible that anyone is still alive. Now, if the mountain and nothing there can actually connect with Gabura, that would be the best case scenario here. Gabura is still taking damage from Blue Star. Everyone's still taking damage from Blue Star. Nothing there looks like he may have gotten the mountain back down to level 2. Auryune has been moved next to the hallway of Baynard. I really hope that they go in there. Big Bird's coming out. We need to be careful of Big Bird actually possessing Baynard. There's the black attack there from the mountain. Gabura is still waiting inside of Hod's department. And is the mountain going in there? No! Nothing there is connected with Baynard again. Baynard, we gotta go. Okay, Baynard was able to get out of there. Nothing there is hot on his trail. Gabura still doesn't have any abnormalities on her. I don't know if this is going to be feasible here, especially from a watchability point. Nothing there is still trying to get at Baynard. If we can slow him down and let the mountain catch back up, if we can neutralize nothing there, Baynard to be safe for now. But the problem is that we need someone to go after Gabura. Luckily, we have the teleporting elevator trick on our side here. Nothing there really wants a piece of Baynard. Let's try to lead them over to Gavira. Yeah, one thing I need to make sure of is that we don't cross Meat Lantern. Mountain's back at level 3. There's plenty of bodies. Okay, that's Forsaken Prisoner. Let's walk Baynard through Gabira's room here. Excuse me. Here comes nothing there. Queen of Hatred teleported right on top of Baynard. Here comes nothing there. Will nothing there go inside of Gabira's room? I think he is. And now the real fight is on. Gabira versus nothing there. Big hit by nothing there. Remember, Gavira does take, huge hit! 270 damage from nothing there's execution attack. And that caused Gavira to run. Baynard needs to be careful though, because we don't know where the portals are going to be. Nothing there, carrying the team. We need to slow down nothing there, he's catching up to Baynard. We also don't have unlimited bullets here, too, so we need to be very cautious with our damage. So I think the key here is going to be... Now that I think about it... I don't think we need to do the Flesh Idol. I think I have a better way to deal with this. I'll let this day play out, but not for much longer, because I realize that it's, like, absolutely not watchable. But I have an idea that might be more doable without having to lag the entire game to hell. Because if we can influence who nothing there goes after... We don't need to have all the other abnormalities out. So as long as we can get nothing there to breach, we can lead him to Gabira with Baynard without having the game to run at like 3 frames every 10 seconds. But our first question is still not answered. We don't know if just because Gabira's HP goes to 0, will that end the day, despite us not having any power accrued? So Baynard and Gabira are just going toe-to-toe right now. Huge hit, that's 270 damage. That's gonna send Gabira to phase 2, so... Okay. I'm gonna stop this day here just because like the frame rate is actually terrible. I'm sure all of you have noticed for the last 20 minutes now. But I think that we can do that there. So that's what I'm going to do. So for tomorrow, what we will do is my plan is this. It's still going to be the same plan. We're going to have Baynard get the blessing from the Knight of Despair, and then after that, we're going to breach nothing there. We don't need to sacrifice Neville. What we can do is we can have somebody breach nothing there, and then we will be if he always goes after Baynard, who's going to be the only employee left. We should be able to influence who he goes after, meaning that Baynard should be able to trail him into Gabira, wherever she is, And as long as we keep him safe, we should be able to deal with this. Now, one thing I am worried about is other abnormalities getting out, but it's going to be far less laggy than the 20 minutes of hell we just saw. So thank you for watching, everyone. Again, sorry about the lag. There's no way I that's purely the game. I don't know what I could have done about that. But I think we have our setup. We're going to go tomorrow and give it the experimental treatment might actually be the payoff here. And if not, then we'll have to go and old school it and just micro around her. So we'll see. We'll see. But thank you again for watching, everyone. I do appreciate it. Sorry about the broken frames. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.